begin with a story. Once upon a time, there were two young monks in a monastery, and they were told by an older monk, the gardener, to weed a particular patch. And the older monk went away on a journey. And the two young monks looked at the patch, and the more they looked at it, the more it seemed to them that everything growing in it was weeds. So they thought, well, this is very simple. And so they dug up everything and cleared it. And the older monk returned, and he was not happy. Because indeed, among the weeds, there had been some priceless flowers and other such things. Well, by the strange workings of God's providence, one of those young monks is now the abbot of Pluskerton, and the other one is now the bishop of Aberdeen. And we hope that they have learned something about spiritual gardening in the meantime. Well, yes, today's first reading from the Book of Wisdom, and then the parable of the wheat and the darnel, both touch on something very mysterious and that very affects each of us. The place of what's wrong, what's not right, what's bad, what's evil, within the providence of God. How do these two fit together? It's a famous question. The first reading mentions human insolence or arrogance and sin. The gospel speaks of a weed-sowing enemy, of the devil and his offspring, of offenses, scandals, and evil-doing. And the second reading also mentions our weakness. And there it is. And we know these things, the mystery of evil in ourselves, in others, in our Christian communities, in the world, even in nature. And I think the readings are offering us, let's say, God's take on these things, or God's approach, a divine strategy. He is sovereign, says the Book of Wisdom. He is in charge. He cares. He cares for everything. He helps us in our weakness. He is patient. He is forbearing. He is content to wait. He says, let both grow until harvest. There is a time for everything. I think the readings are inviting us to imitate God in the way we respond to evil. We are being invited to respond not in our way, which may be that of let's pull up all the weeds, but in his way. We're being asked to go with the grain, as it were, of God's working and not against it. Well, I really do want to be brief, so just a few thoughts. We can, I think, waste a good deal of emotional and mental energy trying to work out where the bad things, the wrong things come from. Why has this happened? Why has this happened to me? I mean, these are natural questions in a way and sometimes appropriate, but often not especially helpful. It's better to think not backwards, as it were, but forwards. So what is this for? How do I meet it, respond to it? How do I turn it to good? It's as if the purpose is more important than the cause. And so I think it's good to think a little more like this. You know, we are seed, each of us, sown in the world. And everything that happens to us is to help us grow towards our harvest. And if we think of ourselves as Christians, then thanks to our baptism, we have, as it were, a compass in us, or let's say that a compass needle, and that needle points to God, it points to heaven, it points to the harvest. Or we could think of ourselves as having a kind of mysterious inner digestive power, so that whatever we have to partake of in life, we can turn to our nourishment rather than to our destruction. I think European stomachs are quite weak and easily upset because we have been so used to processed and sterilized food. And therefore, anything that's got a little bit of a bug in it, we get upset. Whereas people who, from their childhood, have been eating food with more bugs in it, in fact, develop a stronger stomach, and so things do not have to come back out again, but are turned to good within them. There's a kind of mysterious alchemy of grace which enables us to turn even the base metals into gold. Now, one doesn't want to be facile or flippant about this, but everything can be an occasion for growth in faith, hope, and charity. The last word of the first reading is a vital word, repentance. We shouldn't be afraid of it. Do you not know, St. Paul says, that God's patience is calling us to repentance, that everything that happens to us can become an occasion for our conversion, whether it be according to the ordinary standards, good or bad. Everything is to help us towards the harvest. God can even turn our darnel into wheat. So there is a good sense in which we should take everything personally, because everything is for our personal growth. Everything is for our sanctification. Everything can be turned to the purpose, the God's purpose, of making us saints, holy and blameless before him. So patience, what is patience? It isn't, oh well, we'd better just put up with this. There's an element of that, of course, but it is something more proactive. It is entering into God's timing. You know, you're welcome to Moscow Airport, where the local time is, da da da, please adjust your watches where you've come. Well, we need to adjust our watches to God's time, to God's hour. The servants want to rush out and get rid of the weeds, but we may get it wrong. Darnel is famously hard to differentiate from wheat when it is young. So the Lord says, leave it to the angels to do the sorting out. We should just try to overcome evil with good, repay curses with blessings, and always against the blessed horizon of hope. Evil will be burned up. It will come to an end. And good will shine out. May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, was the Alleluia verse, enlighten the eyes of our mind so that we can see what hope his call holds for us. O Lord, said the psalm, you are good and forgiving, a God of mercy and compassion, abounding in love and truth, for you are great and do marvelous deeds, you who alone are God. Now, we can say these things even now. We can experience God's goodness now. We can experience his power his mysterious magical power, we may say, to turn evil into good. But what we experience of that now, and what we long to experience, is really a mere sip of the chalice. It's like these little, as it were, wafer-like hosts that we receive at Mass. It is nothing to the flood of joy, to the banquet that awaits us, if amid the trials of life we hold to faith, we hold to hope, we hold to love, we try, as it were, to sing in tune with God, we try to change our watches to his time, his working.